Hey folks, welcome back to Skies of Arcadia Legends, and we are now just about to go up against our fourth fight against Piastol. To bring you up to speed, I did a few things off camera. We went and went back to find all the rest of the moonfish that I hadn't collected before, and handed them in to Doc. And we developed the plot a little bit about Piastol, and we found out a little bit more of Ramirez's backstory. We found that Doc actually served on a ship alongside Ramirez and Admiral Mendoza, and Mendoza's betrayal of Ramirez was what sent him down the dark path and sent him to Lord Galcian, and desiring power above everything else. And we also found out that Doc and Doc rescued Piastol's sister from the ship in which Piastol thinks her sister died. So now we are about to go up against the hardest fight against Piastol that we will ever have.
On guard!
She is just not determined to not listen to us. So, you know the strat by now.
I shall have my revenge at last!
No, you won't. Okay, so you use a glyph of might. I also topped up some essential items. Delta shield. Focus. Just a shield. Well, you know, start off as usual. Okay, we'll get this out of the way first of all, and we'll see just how much this hurts. Damn, jeez, that's a lot of health. Okay, so next turn, Fina, you are just gonna keep up the healing. I'm gonna have to take that off you at some point. So, how about Vice does some healing? You do your thing. Not really worth using that just yet, actually. I mean, I'm gonna end up back down at 11 spirit. Really not getting anywhere. We'll let them keep it for now. Damage from an AoE, that is going to make our lives difficult. I will say this. Okay, and Vice is now turned to stone. Great. And now they pop a new sacrum. It definitely has to die quickly. Okay. So we're kind of falling behind a little bit here with a lot of things. You know. Kind of hoped we'd have had a Pirate's Wrath off by now. I wouldn't have used lunar light.
On guard!
Oh god, this is gonna sting. If it wasn't for the fact that Vice had been turned to stone. Ooh, she seems to choose added to this. Oh yeah, that hurt. Okay, Vice. It's a cruel crystal time.
Yeah.
know at least that with just a shield up, she can't one-hit KO us. So we just need to keep on top of the healing. Please don't turn him to stone. Damn it! Now we have a problem.
Here goes.
These status effects are going to be pretty deadly. Because now we don't have just a shield. Pirate's Wrath. Switch to red. I can only hope that she doesn't use Tempest Dance this turn. Going after Vice. Vice should be able to withstand this. No! Vice cannot withstand that.
Let's try this!
Okay, I can see why this is the hardest. Just think of the spirit points we'll have though at the end of this. Jesus! Twice in a row! Anyone else think this is slightly unfair? She can use her main attack twice in a row. Okay, Vice doesn't have Incremus on him anymore. We've got to get rid of that hound. You've got to get Delta shielded. Sacrum Crystal, just a shield. We've got to get this. I've got to get on top of this. Okay. Damn it! Oh, so close to killing it.
Try this.
I don't know who you're healing, but okay, fine, you're healing yourself. The good news is, he doesn't seem to be using magic. I don't know if she will use magic again. Survive Tempest Dance if she uses it. keep us up with Sacrum Crystal. Rizalum Crystal. Just a shield. I've got to get him cured at some point soon as well. And I kind of can't. Apparently can't skip this one. Oh no. Okay. Well, this is going to be very annoying. Right. Okay. Rizalum crystals. This is quickly getting away from us. Okay, so she's just straight up attacking, that's fine. You're gonna do your healing thing, that's fine. You need a Glyph of Might. You need a Delta Shield. You need Lunar Light. And you need just a shield. Let's get rid of... Heal everybody up fully. Get rid of fatigue. I mean, we're just wasting so much bloody spirit here. Don't turn to stone. Whatever you do, do not turn to stone. Damn it! See, this is the problem you get into. You spend so much time trying to bloody status heal. Just keep yourself alive. You can't lay anything on her.
On guard.
Got to take that bloody Incremus off her. But there's no point doing that until I can kill the Death Hound, because the Death Hound is just going to put it right back on. Jesus, 3010. Dog is just gonna slow heal everybody back up to full, because it takes so many bloody turns to be able to get a heal, get a hit in on it again.
Let's try this.
I think it might be worth just sacrificing one of the shields this one and going for a Pirate's Wrath on it, no matter what. Sacrificing both the shields. She's used Tempest Dance. You just cut this fury it. Wish there was a way. I mean, I could always try and cast Silenus on it, but knowing my luck, it would just fail. Not enough, but at least it'll undo a couple of heals. It's worth it to do it again this time round. Okay, whatever you do, don't turn Vice to stone, because if you do, I'm going to be very annoyed. Yes! Deathhound is gone, no more heals. Okay. Focus. Delta shield. Luna wins. Whoa! When did you get so low health? Vice, forget that focus. You're on Cruelin Crystal for this. How did I not notice that? Did he get Tempest Danced or something? And I just missed it? Okay, this is not gonna work, so that's fine.
Here goes!
She can't get that back now because she doesn't have her magic casting pup. So, Glyph of Might for Vice, Delta Shield, Focus, just a shield.
May righteousness be our shield, shield of justice!
Hopefully now she can't one-hit KO Ica Fina. I suppose actually with just a shield she can't. When she one-hit KO Ica, we didn't have just a shield on. Worth getting Glyphs of Might actually on everybody, because it'll boost their defense. Maybe not, though. Color. Okay. Without the pup to worry about now, we are we're in manageable territory. And if she's going to keep trying to use a turnum, you know, it's just going to ping off us. Oh yes.
Let's try this.
Even the music, thanks for in a good spot now. Weird actually about boosting people's defense, because I'm going to be keeping just a shield up all the time, so she can't one hit kill anyone. Full turn as I want to do it costs 27 spirit. So that's my target, 27. She's just using a turn all the time. Does she not realize we're blocking magic? Oh, so close, I could actually probably cut this fury right now.
Let's try this!
Worth a shot if I have enough spirit to keep my shields up too. She is just obsessed with Enrique. You wanna put your sword up and block this at any point, Enrique? You're just sort of standing there and taking it. Oh, so close. Hopefully she doesn't use Tempest Dance on him one more time. She may not live to tell the tale. And we'll end up just taking her out. And he'll get no experience. Okay, Deluge. Live with this. 1,000 damage to everybody, that's fine. That's nothing. Bye bye, Piastol.
Is it over already?
And that's how we do with the blue roof. 10,000 experience, nice. The only one who doesn't level up is Fina. Oh, a tight dress. Yeah, this doesn't make much sense. Why was she, if she knows we're telling the truth, why is she still coming after us? She is just obsessed with revenge, even if it's not the right person. She wants us to kill her. they seem so overjoyed for someone who spent, you know, be talking to someone who spent most of their time trying to murder them. Yeah, if you really were the Angel of Death, Piastol, we wouldn't be standing here. We could use her on our team, you know. Well, you know, seeing as we're going up against one of the biggest dangers ever faced in the world of Arcadia. Having her around would be kind of nice, you know. And with that, end Piastol's story. We can almost get back to doing our own story. But I have some other things I want to wrap up as well. Stuff that's probably better done off camera. Because I'm sure you guys would find it boring as crap. I have two of the three Abrek charms in the game. And with to do the last one, I have to do a trading quest from Esperanza, which is why I got the kale way back when we were at Yafatuma, from that discovery. And with that, I'll have the third Abrek charm to give to Cubel. I then need to find the one charm I'm missing from outside Soltis. I know, that's going to be a pain. Then I guess I could, I've got all the crew members. I guess I could go on a discovery hunting quest. I might record that. You might come to see, might get to see it with me. But it's going to be a lot of sailing around. A lot of stuff you've seen before, so maybe not. Maybe I'll just zip through and show you the interesting bits. And then it'll be on to Soltis to take on Ramirez and bring this whole thing to a close. But for now, thanks for watching, folks. And we'll see you next time on Skies of Arcadia Legends. Goodbye.